All right, when it comes to password managers with the most loyal communities, it's hard to find a bigger rivalry than LastPass versus 1Password. But is this loyalty warranted? So in this video, I'm going to explore whether either of these providers are worthy of your attention and money. All right, I'm going to start with the elephant in the room, the security history of both password managers. Now, since 2022, LastPass's name has become synonymous with security breaches. Sad, but true. All right, it's been involved in numerous breaches that affected a lot of this password manager's users. Furthermore, recently, federal agents confirmed LastPass's involvement in a $150 million crypto heist. Yeah, I don't take such things lightly. So with all the controversies in mind, I consider LastPass's reputation significantly damaged. That said, 1Password is not entirely innocent either. In 2023, there was a security incident with the Okta support system. The difference between this issue and LastPass's breaches is that the former have not affected any users and have been transparently explained in a report. At the same time, LastPass attempted to conceal their breach until called out. As you can see, these providers have two very different ways of addressing security concerns, and I think you can tell which one is better. Now, even though LastPass has a tarnished reputation, it might still be, an affordable option if you just need a password manager and security is an afterthought. Now, this is kind of accurate, actually. LastPass's first year is only a couple of dollars per month. And even the family plan is about a dollar cheaper than 1Password's pricing. If you're really strapped for cash, I can see LastPass being a decent, low-budget option. But truth be told, personally, I'll pay a dollar more for a more reputable provider in a heartbeat. So if you also want to invest in a reliable password manager, why not make it cheaper with a discount? Just follow the link in the description or scan this QR code. You'll get the best price cut you deserve. That said, a question still remains, are those providers even worth the price? I mean, what features do they even offer to justify the price? Let's take a look, okay, starting with 1Password. This is a password manager that is well known for its good security measures. Not only does it encrypt all the data kept in the app, but it also maintains the zero-knowledge architecture. For those of you without a CS degree, this means that 1Password doesn't know what you keep in the app since all the cloud backups are encrypted on your device before being sent to the cloud. 1Password is also a great option if you want to keep your password strong and unique. The Watchtower feature sends alerts as soon as it detects reuse, weak, or compromised passwords. It's not hard to keep up with this. I usually just use the password generator to create new, stronger passwords whenever Watchtower starts bugging me. Needless to say, generating passwords for new accounts is also easier than ever. I only have a little ease of use issue that applies to pretty much all password managers due to security reasons. I can't use autofill without a browser extension. So yeah, if you want to fill in forms in one click and avoid copy-pasting every password, you will have to install the extension. My apologies, browser purists. Now, this is not to say passwords are the only way to log in, right? Not anymore. These days, many websites support passkeys, and 1Password keeps up with the trend. If you didn't know, passkeys allow for passwordless login by generating a special access token based on your unique device data. Sounds more secure than a good old password system, right? That's because it is. Now, on the security side, travel mode is another feature that I use frequently. This feature lets me hide specific passwords or even entire folders when traveling. I hate losing devices, but at least I can be sure that if I lose my phone, nobody can access all the crucial info that I keep in 1Password. Of all the password managers I've used, 1Password stands out the most in two ways. First, with its vaults system. I can't name an app that makes managing passwords, documents, and secure notes more convenient than 1Password. It's a very straightforward experience with intuitive controls. And secondly, 1Password is the best password manager for families that I've used. Sharing passwords or even entire vaults takes a single click, but I also have an option of customizing everything when it comes to defining who should have access to what. This is a highly versatile app for family users. So if you're looking for a secure password manager that a whole family can use without watching hour-long tutorials, I can't recommend a better option than 1Password. Remember, if you decide to try it out, this link in the description or this QR code is how you get the best discount. Now, what about LastPass? Can it stand up to 1Password in comparison? Well, Yes and no. Sure, both use encryption on the basic security level. So technically, all LastPass can leak is encrypted data that will take a lifetime to decrypt. But that's in theory. In practice, all the breaches have proven that LastPass leaves some information, such as the user's IP address and URLs visited, unencrypted, despite its zero-knowledge promises. In that regard, it's much more secure to use LastPass in an offline mode, since this eliminates the chances of breaches or leaks affecting you. That said, some features like dark web monitoring, family sharing, and such still require an internet connection, so defaulting to offline access simply cripples the app. Now, the dark web monitoring feature that I've mentioned is similar to 1Password's Watchtower. This feature also detects weak, reused, or leaked passwords, but sadly, it doesn't detect LastPass's breaches. At this point, it's a demanded functionality. Continuing the 1Password versus LastPass comparison, the latter still offers family sharing, passkey support, and vault-based password management. Unfortunately, the experience that I've had with those features is just simply incomparable. LastPass is nowhere as customizable as 1Password. The passkey functionality is limited, and family features require a lot of additional tweaking before they become half as useful as the competitor. I can't even say that I've enjoyed using LastPass on top of already unresolved security issues. I wanted to give both providers a fair chance with this password manager comparison, but it turns out I should have called it quits after all the breaches. There's no doubt that between the two, only 1Password deserves to be called one of the best password manager options. It's secure, easy to use, and offers a lot of effective and well-implemented features. LastPass doesn't hold a candle to 1Password, despite all the opportunities it had to fix security issues and reputational damage. So what do you think? Would you give LastPass a chance even after all the breaches? Let me know in the comments below, and remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. I hope to see you in the next one. Stay tuned.